Mordred is the greatest intrigue and the greatest, I think, enemy, really, of Merlin. But he doesn't know it. Mordred doesn't know that's what he is. So it's a big dilemma for Merlin. Because it's another thing if somebody knows what they're doing. It's a completely different story if they're going about a destiny and a line that they don't know they're destined to do. So it's hard to try and stop someone who is so well-meaning and so consistent. Or is it? Are they just a really good actor? So Merlin's got so many questions going on, and it's really highlighted in this episode because Mordred, at one stage, really begs for Merlin's help. Merlin doesn't really know whether to trust him, and he makes it obvious that he doesn't ever make it easy for Mordred. He never has to be his friend or to really anything, because Merlin has essentially hidden himself all his life, and Mordred has supposedly put to bed everything that Merlin believes in to become a knight and to repress his magical side and done all that. So there's a lot of resentment, I think, from Merlin and for personally, but also in the future wise, he is destined to kill Arthur. So I think Merlin inadvertently is going about trying to make things as best as they can be in this episode, and they don't work out. Mordred goes to the dark side by the end, and he betrays me.